Welcome all of you to Nissan Stadium on the banks of the Cumberland River in downtown Nashville, Tennessee. The scene a few moments ago, here it is. It's unlike any other in sport as both teams made their way out of the tunnel. These folks are fired up as their guys are ready to do battle between the Miami Dolphins and the Tennessee Titans. This will be fielded inside the five. And he returns this to the 22.
Noah Igbinoghene on the return. The Dolphins take over first and 10 at their own 22-yard line.
And the Titans going to signal for a timeout defensively. They'll have two remaining as we step aside here in this first quarter. They will get 4 yards here on the first down run, and that'll make it second and six.
At the end of all that hitting and hollering, it was a four-yard run, so the offense is going to go back to huddle and feel pretty good about themselves. Defensively, you have to feel okay because you didn't let it turn into a bigger run, but the goal, shut it down for 2 yards or less. That's when you start to feel good about yourselves.
On the option, here's Tua, and he stopped immediately there. Call it no gain on the keeper, and it's going to bring up a third down.
Well, for that being an option play, there really weren't too many options available for him, were there?
No, there weren't, and at least he was able to get back to the line of scrimmage, so he didn't lose anything, but you're exactly right. Nowhere to go.
Tua going to run again. This is out quickly to the right. The completion there winds up a wash, and it'll bring up fourth down.
That goes in the category of a play that the defense is going to cherish and excites them. A completion, yes, you give up the pass, but no gain. I mean, that's exactly what you want on defense.
It sets up the fourth down. The call for a fair catch, and it's made at about the 23-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt, and it'll be Titan football. Tannehill and the Titans come up now first and 10 at their own 23. Back to throw, Tannehill. And nearly picked off. Surprising to see a defender of his caliber let it get away, but it does get away and it's second down.
Jones on the coverage.
From the gun, here's Tannehill. It's a short one here, complete to his tight end. And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That'll leave him with a third and two coming up. They got 8 yards there.
Second
Second down pass play got him 8 yards. Now they've got a third and a couple remaining.
Check, 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 check. Kill, kill, kill. Slam, slam, slam.
Play, play.
The first carry for the former Nittany Lion. This is Saquon Barkley. And he will have a Titans first down by about a yard as they're able to convert on third and two. A third down gain of 3 yards, and that'll be enough. They keep it with Barkley on first down. And he'll get this one up to about the 39 here. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game and leaned on other people to give them the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
And this play will be blown up. He'll lose yardage back at the 38. It'll be a loss of a couple on the play, so now third down coming up.
This defense is a difficult one to prepare for, one of the best in the league. They'll come at you from all angles, and they did a nice job there stopping him for a loss.
Third down, Tannehill. And that is incomplete.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
And he gets it away. A directional kick going toward the sideline. No returning this one. It sails out of bounds, and they'll spot it right at the 20.
They're on 20-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. And they're coming off a 3-and-out, my friend.
I think they've got to look at that play sheet and go to a spot that they haven't gone before. Time to shake things up a little bit to try and get this offense moving.
Okay, so how do you do that? How do you shake things up?
You look at what you've called before, realize it hasn't worked so well.
Go to something else.
And maybe you try and find one of those special plays from one of your better players and maybe try and hit something big and get things going in the excitement area.
Taken down at the Titans' 27-yard line. It's a big play there for Miami. So that one, just a little touch pass, but it paid off quite handsomely.
Yeah, and let's face it, the quarterback loves it because it pads his stats as a completed pass for nice yardage downfield. I like the way they get the receiver in motion. It's almost like he's running a route before he gets the football because he's got a full head of steam when the ball is popped in his direction.
His throw caught at about the 5. That one goes for 24 yards. So 3 plays already first and goal, and they are wasting little time. They'll run with Sanders. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown. Miles Sanders. His first touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are going to take a first quarter lead. And that makes it 7-0 Dolphins.
Is good. Makes the score Dolphins 7, Titans nothing.
Jason now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive and hoping to do better than they did their last possession when they punted the football.
Appeal to the vanity of your offensive line. Tell them that they control your fate. Leverage guys. Win the line of scrimmage. If you do that, you start to win first down. You win second down. And guess what? You start accumulating first downs. And that's what they need in order to not punt the ball again.
First down carry for Barkley. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 45-yard line. It's a loss of 4 there, bringing up second down.
Michael, right here.
Ready? You ain't going nowhere. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports.
Dolphins 7, Titans nothing.
Throwing on 2nd and 14. Tannehill, he's going to launch this thing way downfield. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Oh, man, that was close. The opportunity to change momentum. Big play right in his hands, unable to come down with it.
A sigh of relief, no doubt, on offense that that fell harmlessly to the ground. Third and long, it's Tannehill. Deep ball for Goodwin. It's caught inside the 25. He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. Able to convert on 3rd and 14. A terrific play call.
The 22-yard line.
So the big play gets him all the way down to the outskirts of the red zone here for 1st and 10. Now Saquon Barkley. And he will lose yardage here back at the 23-yard line. Officially, it's a 1-yard loss. That's going to bring up 2nd and 11.
Brings up 2nd and 11 at the 23-yard line.
On 2nd and 11 now, Tannehill. This is caught and into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. 23 yards for the touchdown. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. And Barkley will try to punch it in. And this will result in him losing yardage. Back to the 3. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be 2nd down.
A loss of 2 brings up 2nd and goal at the Dolphins' 3-yard line.
Another try for Barkley, and he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. Saquon Barkley, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's up and good, and we're tied at 7 here in quarter number 2. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. Taken about 7 yards deep. And he'll decide to not bring this one out as their drive will begin at the 25. The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked. But you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
A nice run there, 9 yards, and it'll be 2nd down.
Brings up 2nd and a yard at the 34-yard line.
Now a handoff looking right. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. 15 yards on the play, 1st down.
A good run there off right tackle in an old school NFL football. The right side, the offensive line, often known as the nasty side. The left side, usually the technical side. Kind of reminds me of the old Atlanta Falcons 2009-2010. That's how they constructed their offensive line.
And incomplete as he was knocked as he threw it. And it took the ball off course.
2nd down and 10.
So after the incompletion on 1st, now 2nd and 10. Shotgun snap and then the give to Sanders. And he's up over midfield and down into Tennessee territory. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a third down.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get them into a manageable third down, because they had incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
Under pressure here, and down he goes. Sack back at about the 43-yard line.
It's Jeffrey Simmons that time who got in to record the sack. Pilardi now on to punt as he sends this one away. This is taken at about the 14. It's a 40-yard punt, 4 yards on the return. And the offense will take over with a new set of downs. Tennessee offense about set and ready to go. And they'll be looking to build off of a nice drive last time, a drive that really relied on the quarterback.
Making good decisions, distributing the ball well, distributing it accurately, keeping it away from danger. A really nicely run drive.
But now the defense, what adjustments do they need to make in the passing game?
Pass rush, pass rush, pass rush. Whether it's the guys up front, or maybe you bring additional guys, but you've got to disrupt the timing of them throwing the football.
We'll see if they can disrupt it here. And we'll remind you that coming up at halftime, we'll join Jonathan Coachman and the gang in Orlando. Coach will have stats and scores from the early games going on here around the NFL. And he's going to get this one down to the 30. Not quite the success they had last play. This one goes for 3 yards.
A 3-yard pickup brings up 2nd and 7.
From the 30 on 2nd down, Tannehill. His throw caught at about the 5. Touchdown, Titans.
The kicker on for the extra point.
CD, for them, this has just been an offensive explosion here in the second quarter.
Yeah, held scoreless in the first quarter. Now they find the end zone again here in the second. Sometimes you just have to have some patience. A lot of people think it's always an adjustment. You have to change what you're doing. Sometimes you just have to do your game plan just a little bit better. And I think that's part of what we're seeing here.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback. Now they try the right side here. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down. Seemed like a couple sets of eyes were on the quarterback, so he decided, hey, I'm going to hand this off. Got a good gain out of it.
And you know you need good blocking up front in order to gain yardage, but every one of these RPOs, if you do it right and they look the same. But...
And the Titan defense steps up here, and down he goes. Melvin Ingram dropping the hammer off the edge. Well, they go play fake. The problem is nobody was faked out.
And when no one's faked out, what's the end result? Quarterback gets hit.
Tua wants to throw it on 2nd down. Got an open man. It's Foster. Now the Dolphins going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop the clock with 24 seconds to go in this first half. Out of the gun on 3rd down, here's Tua. That's complete to his tight end, Mike Gesicki. And he goes out of bounds and looks like right at the 50. Tua finding Gesicki there for a Dolphin first.
First down, Miami.
From midfield, here's Tua. Throwing the out route and complete. It's Fuller. The Dolphins going to take their 2nd timeout as it'll come with 15 seconds to play in the first half.
And the Dolphin first down.
Ball up to the 35 now as they come up on 1st and 10. Off of play action, Tagovailoa steps away to his left. He'll let it go deep for Foster. And that is incomplete. 7 seconds remaining. Robert Foster, the intended receiver. And that'll bring up 2nd down.
Leads to 2nd and 10 at the 35-yard line.
Tua setting up shop to throw again. Quick hitter here. It's complete. And he'll be out of bounds, able to get it down to the 25 there. 9 yards, not quite enough, and they'll be left now with 3rd and 1. So 3 seconds here remain in the half. On is the field goal unit to see about getting 3 points. On the left hash, it's a 42-yard attempt. Sanders' kick is good. So we've reached halftime here in a 4-point game. As we'll send you down to Orlando, we check in with Jonathan Coachman for our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach.
Kickoff for Miami.
Sanders now to kick this one away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Titans offense set to begin the drive, and they're hoping to redo their efforts in the last drive when they got into the end zone.
And just think of what it's like now on the sideline, because when you score a touchdown, you have to go over and look at the tablet and see what you did on the last drive. When you score points, it's a whole lot better view than when you're trying to figure out how to fix things there.
Officially nothing on that last run. They'll try again 2nd and 10.
At the 25-yard line.
Here's Tannehill. He's got his man on the crossing route. Touchdown, Titans! A big play there. His 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts. All right, because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
This will be fielded inside the 5. Now a crease here as he's past the 30. And good starting field position. He'll get this one all the way up to about the 35-yard line.
At their own 35-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And tough to win games if you're going field goal, field goal, field goal here. They got field goal last time. Now they'll be looking for a touchdown.
Looking for the big chunk now because, as you noted, the field goal, field goal, field goal way of doing it makes it that much harder. It puts more pressure on every possession for you now. Go ahead and get 6 and feel a lot more comfortable about the position they're in.
Bigger chunks. We'll see if they can get the score. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Now this time, Tua is going to throw it. Into a double team, and it's intercepted. Picked off at the 39. CD, I know it's just his 2nd year in the league as a quarterback, but that's going to be one when he flips on the tape. He's like, ah, I shouldn't have thrown that ball.
No doubt about it, and his coaching staff will be emphatic about he shouldn't have thrown that ball. But remember, 2nd year, as you noted, on the job training, so he's got to take this feedback that he's getting, negative or otherwise, and turn it into positives moving forward.
And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49. 10 yards there to start the drive, and just enough by about the length of the football for a 1st down.
1st and 10 at the 49-yard line.
Across midfield and into Miami territory.
Barkley on the handoff.
They give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. That one, a 1st down pickup of 8.
Well, we've seen running backs in today's NFL get involved in the passing game. Maybe it's about time more receivers like that get involved in the running game.
And that is something we are seeing more and more in this league, no question about it.
That wasn't the biggest of gains, but it was enough to get him a first down. And it continues to test the defense. They have to think on every play about who might end up with the ball.
Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and nine.
Brings up second and nine.
They'll try the air now with Tannehill. That's complete to a speedy wideout, Goodwin. And they'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. A gain there of 21 yards. On first down, Barkley. And he'll be taken down at the 2-yard line. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Lots of praise on this drive, obviously. I know you're seeing what I'm seeing. Those guys up front, they're getting it done.
Doesn't matter what play is called, they are handling their business at the line of scrimmage and dominating right now on this drive.
Now here's Hill. And just a short gain that time as they're able to get him down. He'll get two out of that run, and it's going to bring up a second and goal. Looking at this now, you got a couple more cracks here. This close, sneak it.
I don't think he even go into a huddle. Just line up, snap it, and fall in behind those guys into the end zone.
They'll run it with Hill. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. That's a big loss of three, and it brings up third down.
That's a really alert defense there because they saw the heavy look come in from the offense, countered it with extra linebackers who brought a little bit of speed and heft, and able to really make a big-time play for their defense.
Line of scrimmage at the four. Here's third and goal. Now here's Goodwin with it on the jet sweep. And he goes backwards on this one, losing yardage to the seven. And a loss of three to bring up fourth.
They try to catch him by surprise there on third down, but this defense, they were all over the jet sweep.
And it's oftentimes all about what you're doing on the backside of the defense, whether it's the defensive end or the outside backer, who's setting the edge. And if they don't get blown off the line of scrimmage, they can really wreck a play, and in this case, they were able to make the tackle for a loss as a result.
And the 13-year man puts it through, and that will get the lead up to 14. That drive took him inside the 10. Good job defensively to hold him to three.
Yeah, I like how you did that. Give a little tip of the cap to the stop troops there because they didn't give up a touchdown in that situation, right? Made them kick the field goal. And, yeah, points went against them, but that feels a whole lot better running off the field.
The Dolphins take over first and 10.
The Dolphins at the line ready for their next drive. And here we are almost through three quarters of play, and this passing game still has not really found any kind of rhythm.
Put it mildly, because they're not even over 100 yards yet. And in today's NFL, where it's a pass-first league, that is quite surprising. Not many teams patient enough to stick with the run. Everybody wants to advance the ball through the air. They've got to get their timing back.
And this should be the final play before the quarter ends. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he'll be brought down on what's going to turn out to be the final play of this third quarter. Back now in Nashville. It's Dolphin football, but they trail here as we get set for the fourth. The Dolphins on third down. Just one for three thus far. This is third and eight. On play action, here's Tua. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. A Miami first down on a 14-yard pickup.
A gain of 14. First down, Dolphins.
Tagovailoa working out of the gun. He's going to drop this down to Sanders. 7 yards on the play, and it's a second down. You got the big lead defensively. Willing to give him that underneath stuff, right?
And this is why you work on your tackler. Tackle him after the catch, inbounds, keep the clock running. Just go ahead and bleed the game out that way.
And he's able to get this to the 40-yard line before he's out of bounds. It's a first down on a gain of 10.
Good yardage on the completion there. And when they look at the scoreboard, they do understand a field goal is not going to do them any good. My guess, they're going to press the ball downfield as far as possible, try and throw it into the end zone and get a score because they know they've got to get that done and get the ball back as quickly as possible.
Tua now on first down. He's going to fire one deep left sideline. Now a clash of bodies here, and it's intercepted. Picked up by Dane Cruikshank.
If they had designs of kind of wiggling their way back into this one, that hurts their chances right there.
Yeah, to put it mildly, we look at the lead, look at the deficit, trying to make a play downfield. Everyone seeking to be somewhat the hero. Didn't turn out that way at all, and you're exactly right. It's going to take a lot for them to have a chance to win this one now.
They begin the drive with Hill. And he's going to be taken down shy of the five-yard line. Big Geno Atkins there to bring him down.
Got to figure now, after getting that turnover, they're just going to be happy to keep the ball on the ground, right?
This is where covering the football, taking care of the ball, all the ball security terms that have ever been used, they come into play for the guys on offense right now. Just take care of it, and they've got a good chance of ending up winning this game.
The run only got a yard. Here's second and nine. And he'll find a little space. He gets this up near the 10. Call it a gain of 5 that time, and they'll be left with a third and about 4.
The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Yeah, don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And he's free going down the left side. It's a foot race. Past the 20. Touchdown, Titans. Three touchdown passes now for Ryan Tannehill, and the Titans are able to extend their lead. They were still throwing with a comfortable lead here late, and now that lead even more comfortable.
And your first thought is it bad blood that went into this one ahead of time, that maybe they're seeking some revenge or they just don't like them? But the other thing that always hits me is, are they worried about playoff positioning, right? Are they worried about, do you need enough points in case there's a tiebreaker that comes into play later?
25-yard line.
The Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. Their mini two-game win streak appears it might be going by the wayside unless they can pull a rabbit out of their hat. And he'll be upended at the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. The tackle was by the Boston College product, Harold Landry. Here's second and 7 now from the 28.
The 28-yard line.
Now a handoff looking right. He'll have a first down past the 40. And all the way down to the 41-yard line.
We'll definitely see some open running lanes, and he's taking advantage of it right now, but that shouldn't be a surprise. Defense has the lead. They're playing for the pass first.
So the big play gets him across midfield now for first and 10. Going to give this time to the tailback. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and 5.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
Saw it through three quarters. No reason to lighten up now.
A really good pickup of 28 yards. Clock management definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agreed. They have to up the tempo in this case. Down a couple of scores, want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. As Sanders has it pumped free, it's picked up by the Titans, and he's going to get this one to the 23-yard line.
And with that kind of a deficit, you can't afford to make any kind of mistakes. But it's been pretty symptomatic of what we've seen all game with them, isn't it? Down this big in the fourth.
Yeah, you'd say an afternoon to forget. Absolutely.
And a nice run past the 30-yard line there. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and 3.
a 7-yard.
So the Titans in possession of the football here as we get you reset. And no doubt what they're looking to do is just salt away the final couple of minutes and escape with a win. They'll go to Barkley again. And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Saquon Barkley, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. And he's been a busy man, 5 for 5 now, as he knocks another one through to extend the lead.
38, Dolphins 10.
The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. Taken about 7 yards deep, and this will not be brought out. It's a touchback.
At their own 25-yard line.
Dolphins at the line, ready for their next drive. They've lost this one. Their offense has struggled. Do they try to put together something here at the end just to take into next week?
Yeah, sometimes teams want to do that, and coaches want to. I remember one time I was on a team, and we were losing late in the game like this, and you knew it was lost. It was over, right? And a coach called a running play and pretty much said to everyone, I want to see something executed well before we get out of here. And that was the message to the team.
Just something to build on.
Just something to build on. Get it done. And maybe we can look at that and say, we'll get better as we go forward.
So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. And this winds up a gain of 4 to the 41. Not a whole lot there. The defense was ready, it looked, for that run-pass option.
You get the sense that next time he has that opportunity, he may keep it himself and get to the perimeter. Probably owes his back a little bit of an apology on that one, huh?
And he takes it past the 45 and down at the 46.
Man, these guys may not win this ball game, but you certainly can't fault the effort of this man here today. He's been a real thorn in their sides all afternoon. And that last carry puts him over the 100-yard mark.
Now a desperation throw. Got a man, it's caught inside the 10. And he will take it in for a Dolphins touchdown.
Touchdown, Miami.
Will Fuller. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Dolphins are able to draw a bit closer. And that'll cut the lead back now to 21.
Makes the score Titans 38, Dolphins 17. Jason Sanders to kick off for
Miami. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And they'll indeed take a knee. So this one, a Tennessee Titan victory. And they were buoyed, Charles, by a big second half that put this one on ice.
So you get the sense that whatever was said at halftime obviously hit home. I think it's a little bit more than that, though. Obviously, there are words that are said, and hey, come on, guys, we have to play better. But sometimes it's just sharpening your execution, sharpening your focus, and maybe doing the things you practiced all week without major adjustments, just doing them better. And that got it done in this one.
So for Tennessee, they're on a nice early roll as they move to 3-1 with a win here. And they'll hit the road next week to take on the Houston Texans. Meanwhile, for the Dolphins, they'll fall back to 500 at 2-2. And they'll look to get back on the beam next week as they host the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. And for Charles Davis and our entire crew here at EA Sports, I'm Brandon Gordon saying so long, everybody.
Just a little hiccup. I did be ballin' this pickup. Remember me being so bummy and being so hungry, I had to eat gristle. How did the lady go miss? How she was magic, she mixed. Met her at one of the functions, we caught a little rhythm. She caught up a friend, they kissed and we dipped it, and that's how we kicked it.
Let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I asked, can I?
Before I went live, they ain't know what I was. Ain't no one alive that could do what I does. Wait. Need a light year just to catch my buzz. He's right here just to catch my cup. Now they don't really talk about us. Now they don't really talk about love. Honestly, they ain't never seen too much. What's love to a guy with a bag? What's heart to a guy with a cash? What's pain to a guy that's mad? Said. What's broke to a guy with a mask? What's broke to a guy with a plan? I just wanna kick it, that's all I ask. Like,
let me explain what I did. Can I kick it? Hold on. Yeah, I got some rings and a range. Can I kick it? Yeah. Don't ask me a thing. How I got her, how I did it. Yeah. Spend the whole half, had a blast. Can I kick it? Even with a sprain. Pain, can I kick it? Just the flex, I went and bought a chain. Can I kick it? Things ain't been the same. Things have changed. Can I kick it? People acting different, so I ask, can I?
For the wins, came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Yeah, I got it right in the end. Ay. Now we on top, top once again. I don't want it if it ain't love. If it ain't get it away from me. Who you gonna jack if it ain't us? LABB to the bakery. Some mad that I came up. I know my granny gonna pray for me. It was just us in the vacancy. We had to get it from A to B. Wheels never felt like this. Two seats in the hills, how I feel righteous. Blue sheets for the mills, but the deal priceless. New keys can't care what's built private. I might just double it up, did it. Never enough, I'm with it.
5-2-3 on the business. Whole team got wins in the world suspended. I told them we did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah, hey, I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top. Got a spot and it's locked to the click all in. I got ops, if he drop, I just hit my dance. I was top, they just watched, had to take my wins. They wouldn't let me in, I've been on 10 cents. Who really holding it down? I've been holding it down and I go it again and again. Who was the dummy that died? I'm the coldest around, but he folding again and again. I'm in the what? I'm in the day. I'm doing 30 on 30 and up. You in the what? You in the way. Either you rolling or rolling the dust. You with us or what?
Keep it running.
We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. I got it right in the end. Now we on top, top once again. We did a lot for the wins. Came in a drop on a 10. Now we on top, top once again. Yeah. I had to tighten the plan. Got it right in the air. Now we on 10.
I got an antidote to retain some kind of self-control. Look inside my head through a telescope. You erase all the calls from a telephone. No sense of smile, maybe tell a joke. Holding back your tears, singing minute.